Can you tell me what is common between a frying pan, a rope to hang your clothes, an airtight container, and a pair of slippers? Apart from the fact that they are all very useful in everyday life, another common thing is that they are made up of long chains of repeating units. In simple words, they are made up of polymers. What exactly do we mean by polymers? As the name suggests, poly in Greek means many, and mer refers to units. So can we say many repeating units joined together? Yes, that's exactly what it means. And these units are all the same. That means the basic unit that forms the polymer will repeat itself several times. Do we know what the single unit is called? Yes, it's called a monomer. So a monomer repeats itself many times to form extremely long chains which form nothing but a polymer. Polymers can be naturally occurring or synthetic, which means man-made. Now, can you tell me which among these are natural and which among these are artificial? Well, all of them are artificial. Yes, the frying pan has a surface of Teflon, the rope is made up of nylon, the container is plastic, and the slippers are simply processed rubber. Among all these examples, we are going to focus on the rope and the container. We will focus on these two because we need to understand the concept of synthetic fibers and plastics. Wait a second. What do we mean by synthetic fibers? We have always used cotton, wool, or silk, which are naturally occurring. Do we know what synthetic fibers are? Of course we do. The shiny clothes made up of rayon, the warm and soft clothes made up of acrylic are all what we normally use. These are all examples of synthetic fibers. As the name suggests, these are fibers made by man. That means the natural fibers are chemically processed, or maybe we can even mix a few reagents to get these artificial fibers? Yes, absolutely. That is exactly what we do. There are several ways of obtaining synthetic fibers. In the upcoming videos, let us learn about the types of synthetic fibers and their characteristics. Then we will learn about plastics being the material of choice and the effect of plastic on our environment.